Hi, here we will discuss about regular definition to specify the tokens. Here, regular expressions used to represent the patterns which are used for representing the tokens. So, in C language, we are having the different identifiers. That identifiers will denoted by using the letters and digits and underscores. So for this pattern is given here. So the production for the letter will always having the capital A to Z or small a to Z. And in C identifier, C language, C identifier will have the underscore also. So that underscore also added with letter production. Then digit always will have from 0 to 9. Then the identifier, that means identifier in the C language is called variable. So always that variable will have either single letter, or that single letter is concatenation of any number of letters or digits. So here single letter also allowed, then that may have 0 to infinity, that is as per the C rules, more than one letter. For example, so this is variable A, the only single letter. Then here this letter A is concatenated with again this letter, that means underscore. So that is one letter. Then here, so it is this pattern is 0 times appearing, but here that this term is appearing 4 times, that is underscore 1 time, then followed by digit 2 times, 1 and 2, then followed by this letter. So this variable, that is identifier, is having letter, then concatenation of underscore, this belongs to the this letter production, then 1 to this two digits are belongs to this digit production, then b again belong to letter production. So this is valid identifier in the C programming language. Then for the unsigned numbers, we are having the patterns as like digit, that always having the 0 to 9, then the digits in the sense, for example 9. Then digits here, digit, single digit, the single digit are followed by any number of digits, that means 0 to infinity as per the C programming rules. So here the digit, this 9 followed by this clean closure, in the sense here in this example we are having two digits, 5, 2. Then optional fraction, so this is optional fraction is to represent the decimal point. So here after the decimal point there may be any number of digits, the digits means this production will considered here. Then or after the decimal point there might be epsilon means nothing will be there. So here point, decimal point, then the digits, it's having 2, 3. So digit, then digit star, digit is 2, then additionally one more digit is 3 here. Then exponent is represented by using the e, then there may be a positive exponent or negative exponent, or need not to mention the positive symbol or negative symbol. So there is epsilon, then that exponent will be having the any number of digits, that is this production will be considered here. Or there is no need of any exponent. For example, this is positive exponent e, then this plus, from this combination plus, then digits, I took only one digit. Then negative exponent, so e minus 2. Next one is epsilon. So here we didn't use any positive symbol or negative symbol for the exponent. Then the entire number, how it is represented here the entire number is in the form of digits. So digits in the sense any number of digits. So single digit and followed by any number of digits. Then if you need optional fraction, so this is optional. Here if the number may have the integer number, then these two parts are not needed. If it is floating point number, we need this fraction. So this fraction will have decimal point, then any number of digits. After that, if it is exponent, then we may have this exponent e, then positive symbol or negative symbol, or it is epsilon. So if the number is having three combination digit, then fraction, that is floating point number with exponent. For example, so here the floating point number 952.23, exponent positive or plus 2. So for representing the number, if it is only integer, only 952. So here only digits will come. Then if it is 952.23, so this part will not needed. So only digits, optional fraction will be used. So like this, that the number will be represented in the form of a regular expression. And also we can represent integer constant, string constants, reserved words, operators, real constant using the different patterns. And how that tokens are recognizing in the compiler. So here the tokens are recognized by using the finite automata state transition diagrams. The state transition diagrams used to recognize the identifiers, white spaces. The white space includes the delimiters, also relational operators and keywords and numbers. Numbers may be an integer, float or double, whatever it is. Then the branching statement is, that is if statements can be represented in the form of this grammar. So this production statement is derives simple if statement, if then expression then statement. So the statement is true block of statement. So that then or if else statement, if given expression then true statement, else false statements, or it will be epsilon. For example, here statement may be available or that may be a epsilon. That is the usage of this epsilon. Then here expression is having. So for this expression, again, we have to give the production. So expression produces term, relational operator, that will be again term. So or only single term that may have relational operator or may not have relational operator. Then the term is, that may be a variable or that may be a number. If it is a variable, term produces identifier, or if it is the number, then term produces number. And the patterns for white spaces, keywords and operators. So white space will have the blank space, tab, new line character, semicolon, comma, etc. So here, so there should be at least one blank space or one tab or one new line. Then only it will be considered as at least one time it should appear. That's why we are using positive closure. If it is clean closure means that will be zero times. From zero times it starts. That's, but if there is no blank space, that will not consider the white space. So it should be there at least once. That's why we are mentioning the positive closure. Then if produces same keyword if, then produces same the same then, else, again else. Relational operator here, we are having less than or greater than or less than or greater than or equal or not equal. So these are all relational operators. So it does relational operators represented in the form of this production. So we will see the remaining things in the next lecture. Thank you.